Hello and welcome to Strategic News International. I have with me the Ambassador of Venezuela to India, Ambassador Augusto Montiel. Ambassador, what would you like to say about the current political situation in your country?
Venezuela is being challenged by the government of the United States. President Maduro, a legitimate, massively elected president of Venezuela, who respects the Constitution, is being challenged by the President of the United States, who is, through his agencies and through the aggression, with economic sanctions, with military threats, with military aggressions, with the financing of terrorists in Venezuela who are destroying public transportation, electrical installations, power supplies, hospitals, who are burning deposits of medicines, because what they want to do is to control Venezuela, which is the largest oil reserve in the world. The point about this so-called crisis in Venezuela is oil, gold, and the control of the geostrategic region of Latin America. That's what's happening. So the question really should be, why does the United States and international news agencies from Western powers do not inform the world about the economic sabotage, the economic sanctions that they have been forcing on the population of Venezuela, who massively support President Maduro? They have not been shown on TV, they have not been shown on the news that are distributed by the international news agencies. Why? Because then the narrative of a dictator in Venezuela falls, because there is no such a dictator in Venezuela. The information that is shown around the world is the fake news about some dictator, about not being democratic. But it happens that the opposition in Venezuela has not participated in democratic processes because they are following the dictates from the government in North America. And that means that they will try to disrupt every democratic process in Venezuela. Remember, last year, in 2018, the government of Washington boycotted the elections in Venezuela. They didn't want elections. So President Trump was actually internationally calling to boycott the elections in Venezuela. So President Maduro won the elections against the boycotting of the elections by President Trump. And 9.5 million people went out and voted. And they not only voted for President Maduro, they also voted for five other candidates.
But President Trump continues to call President Maduro a dictator. There are accusations of corruption under President Maduro's rule. There is hyperinflation in your country.
What's the problem with hyperinflation? What's the problem with inflation? Is that a reason, for example, to invade a country? So who decides who is the president in Venezuela? The United States? England? China? Who? No, Venezuelans, like Indians, decide who rules in India. You know very well that the North American government has been affecting, sabotaging, and attacking the economy of Venezuela for the last 8 years.
Yes.
They financed and conducted a coup d'etat against President Chavez in 2002, and they recognized the dictator that nobody elected, but that was put there by the United States in 2002. The same people, the same parties, the same politicians who took part in that coup d'etat in 2002 in Venezuela are the same ones, the violent opposition in Venezuela, being financed, being supported by Washington and their puppet governments in the region of Latin America and in other places.
So this is another attempt at a coup and to depose President Maduro?
Definitely, because President Maduro, like President Chavez, is a president who upholds the independence and the sovereignty of every nation. We are living in a 21st century world. Mm-hmm. So civilization calls for the respect of international law, mm-hmm. the respect of international principles, like the United Nations principles, which clearly states that foreign interventions are not accepted, that no country should intervene in internal matters of other countries. So here what happens is that Venezuela is the largest oil reserve. Yeah. So this is an oil war. With many pretexts, many excuses, mm-hmm. the government of the United States has been created an economy crippled by the sanctions, by all the sabotage, with the gangsters that they pay to disrupt. So what President Maduro has been asking for, like President Chavez before, was the respect of Venezuelan sovereignty. Why should Venezuelans accept international interference, international disruption, international aggressions to our system?
What exactly is the U.S. doing where Venezuela's oil industry is concerned?
A Venezuelan company which owns refineries in the United States, mm-hmm. called Citgo, plus 6,000 petrol stations, has been seized by the United States, and the cost of all this is about $20 million, and they have just taken it.
When was this done?
This was done last week. I wonder why Reuters, AP, AFP, and so on haven't told public opinion. Is it because they are hiding this information, this illegal information? Is it because they are hiding that in Venezuela 60% of the population are supporting President Maduro and have been on the streets all these days of January 2019, and were on the streets on the 10th of January when President Maduro took oath, mm-hmm. with the new government, and on the 23rd of January, President Maduro has been there with thousands of millions of people on the streets.
Who is backing this gentleman called Juan Guaido, who's declared himself the president of Venezuela?
Well, obviously, he came out. Nobody knew about him, that person. He was a member of parliament in Venezuela. And let's remember,
he was an opposition leader?
No, he's no leader, absolutely. Okay. They decided that somebody who was not known, because in Venezuela, the opposition has been completely fractured. The opposition has been divided. So this is a person who was chosen and who was trained in Serbia by the intelligence agencies of the United States. And they use this kind of youngsters who have been trained as terrorists and who have been trained to disrupt democracy, not to reinforce democracy.
We've implied that there's a U.S. conspiracy, in fact, actually to hit out at Venezuela, especially the president. But what about the European countries? You know, the European Parliament has...
The European Parliament is participating, and Federica Mogherini, the speaker, she had a press conference yesterday with Uruguayan Minister of Foreign Affairs, mm-hmm. and they accepted that they will participate in an international conference summoned and organized by the president of Mexico and the president of Uruguay, which is not being informed by international news agencies, these Western international news agencies that are always hiding facts and always presenting information from one side, mm-hmm. from the side that benefits the government of Washington or the government of the main Western powers. And they, in the last 2 days, some governments in Europe, not the majority, Europe has 50 countries, and only 11 have yesterday, after the majority of governments of Latin America supported the peaceful initiative, or the initiative for peace, for the construction of peace dialogue, encounter agreements that is being proposed by President Maduro, by the Pope, by the Mexican government, by the Uruguayan government, then it was only when the United States pressurized, the United States government pressurized these European governments to take sides. And now, on the 7th of January, or February, 7th of February, there will be an international conference to bring together the truth about the situation in Venezuela, because nobody in Venezuela, no Democrats in Venezuela want war. The only ones who want war, civil war, violence and blood, are the opposition violent parties supported by the United States government and who now are being directed by the Washington puppet, mm-hmm. who went out and as a clown presented himself as a president.
What is on the agenda of this international conference?
Well, the agenda has been set by Mexico and by Uruguay and by the Pope, who also accepted to be there. Venezuela is not organizing this international conference. Venezuela President Maduro is there when they require his presence. President Maduro has stated again and again that on the basis of the Venezuelan constitution, on the basis of international principle of sovereignty, and that sovereignty cannot, and must not be interfered with, President Maduro can sit down and speak, like he's always done, with opposition parties to stop the violence, to stop destroying Venezuela. And he will continue doing so.
Do you think the U.S. could actually militarily intervene in Venezuela, as has been threatened by President Trump?
He has said it many times. Vice President Mike Pence has used this lately, and he has, together with Secretary of State Pompeo and Security Advisor Bolton, have toured Latin America several times between 2018 and this year. That's how important they consider the Venezuelan oil. And that's why they are using all the mechanisms to force a regime change. And they are using all the mechanisms to apply violence and succeed in a regime change.
I just wanted to take you back to my earlier question on Venezuela's oil supplies to India. Have these been affected? Has there been a drop? How is India making the payments for Venezuelan oil?
Obviously, India has also been receiving end of the decrease in oil production. But Venezuela is doing, and there's been a lot of investment mm-hmm. by different countries internationally to help Venezuela bring up the production, because these North American sanctions are not letting Venezuela even get paid by the oil we sell. That's what they are trying to avoid. This is a war against the Venezuelan capacity to be a powerful state, which, like in the last 20 years, has supported the people of Venezuela. And the only country that has reduced poverty in the whole of Latin American region progressively is Venezuela. That's why Venezuela is one of the first countries in Human Development Index in the region. And in Venezuela, we have 100% literacy, and in Venezuela, we have 100% health service coverage. And in Venezuela, we have, in the last 5 years, President Maduro has been building 3 million houses. Which government has built so many houses? This is public information. And the United Nations specialized mm-hmm. agencies have certified this information.
But there have been charges of corruption against the Maduro regime.
So there's corruption in the last president of the government of Spain was taken out of power because of corruption. They followed their constitution. In Venezuela, we follow our constitution. And if there is corruption, those who are corrupt have to face the law and go to jail. That is what should happen. Or is that a reason? Because if that's the case, all the corrupt people in the United States who, by their corruption, like the banks in the United States, who created the financial crisis that affected the whole world in 2008, should now, that should have been the reason for every other country in the world to invade the United States. Two-thirds of Brazilian Congress, two-thirds, and the direction of Brazilian Congress, and the reason I use the name of Brazil is because Brazil is actually lending its territory for military operations against Venezuela. Two-thirds of the Brazilian Congress, those who actually kicked President Dilma Rousseff out of government and who have illegally kept away President, ex-President Lula from elections, they have all under public, they have been all accused of corruption in Brazil. The same in Colombia. So why don't they apply this same apparent pretext to those countries? Is it because they are friends of the United States?
Different rules for different people.
Ah, okay. So that's not democracy, is it?
Yeah.
That's not democracy. And those who want war, those who want blood, those who are actually creating misery in millions of families in Venezuela cannot be called Democrats. Please.
It was a pleasure talking to you, Ambassador Montiel. Thanks.
Thank you very much.